Okay, now we're going to write the compute for space procedure. First of all, this is just going to involve a couple of conditionals. We're going to say if there's any, we're going to have to ask the turtles to do this, right? Ask turtles if there's any other turtles here, and these are our special words that you'll become more familiar with as you do this, but if there's any other turtles here, die. Turtles here means if you're sitting on a, if you happen to be on a space that contains another turtle, you should just die. So that's the extreme form of overcrowding, right? You don't even.
Okay, now we need to write a procedure for our condition in which turtles will die due to overcrowding. So we need to have a parameter that we set that is related to the overcrowding. So let's call that parameter room. I'm going to add, let's call it space. Okay, I've added a slider here called space. We know that around every turtle, there's a neighborhood of 8 spaces into the north, south, east, west, northwest, southwest, so on. So those 8 spaces, we made a slider that goes from 1 to 8. And I'm going to ask, we can easily count the turtles on the neighbors. So I'm going to say if the count of turtles on neighbors is minus, let's say 8 minus the count of turtles. That gives us, think about that for a second, that should give us how many empty spaces. There's 8 spaces, take away how many turtles are on those empty spaces, and we have how many empty spaces are left. If that number, if the empty spaces is less than the amount of space that a turtle needs to live, then we're going to ask the turtle to die. Okay, so now we've created a condition that requires turtles to die if the empty space, 8 minus the count of turtles on neighbors, is less than the space that they need. And we can set this space, any number from 1 space to 8 spaces. So obviously, if a turtle needs 8 spaces in order to live, they're going to have to be very thinly populated. So you can kind of think of that as a resource that constrains the growth of this population. So I'm going to make a note here: constraint to pop growth. I'm just doing this to illustrate that. Throughout this, we probably should be adding comments so that other people can understand our code, and so that if we come back to this later, we can understand what the parts of the code do. So we complete. Okay, now we have to write our disperse procedure. That'll be our last procedure, and then we will. Okay, to disperse, we need to just ask the turtles to move to one of the patches with not any turtles here. Now, this language is not at all obvious. This requires spending a lot of time looking at the dictionary to make sure. It reads pretty well as English when you see it, but it's certainly not that easy to come up with when you're just beginning programming. So you do. It is good to look at sample code, and this will be one of the chunks of sample code that you can look at to remember all these special words. and how they function. But essentially what we're doing is we're talking to an agent set of patches, a subset of all the patches, those with this property, this conditional met, not any turtles here. So we're looking at each patch, and if it has no turtles on it, then we're going to move to one of those patches. Now, we have to only do this. There's a little tricky thing here. If we were to ask turtles to try to do this, and there weren't any of these patches available, these turtles could just continue trying to find a patch, trying to move this, and this little bit of code would never terminate. So we need to make sure that we add conditions, and we only do this if there's patches. So it's important to only run this thing if the count of turtles, the number of turtles that are on the screen, is less than or equal to the count of patches. Essentially, because it is possible that we could have a situation where we have more turtles than we had patches, and then it would be hopeless because there would be turtles who could never find a home, and the code would just keep running, and we would be wondering what's going on. I speak from experience there. Okay, so I think that should work. So let's see if this whole thing can run now. Still some question there, so we set this up. Let's set a larger initial population. Okay, we still have these things changing color. Let's get rid of the stuff that I added to kind of do an artificial disperse. So I'm going to delete that. And we should be able to keep. Okay, so it looks like something's happening. I'm not sure what, but let's just let's run this up so we can get a higher density, 360. Okay, so when we step, we should have. Okay, and if we require them to need a lot of space, let's see if that makes a thinner population. Indeed it does. And if we require them to have less space, we get higher density. So at first look here, it looks to me like we have a model that's roughly working. Now let's see if we what kind of things occur here when we look at the population. So I'm going to make a simple plot here. And by default, they set a plot that counts the turtles. Now, in order to get this plot to actually plot, we have to do something to the model. And this will happen by default every time we have a tick. So every time we step, I'm going to say tick. Now this will give us an error the first time. Let's just see what error it gives us. If we run setup and then we step, it says the tick counter has not been set up. Use reset ticks. So we have to use this command reset ticks in the setup. I usually do it after my clear all comment. Reset ticks. So, set up. Okay. Well, I'm not sure that was exactly what we wanted. Let's try starting with a lower population and having a kind of a generous thing. Let's see if that works. Initial population 12. Am I doing this right? Huh. It looks to me like our reproduction function isn't working. Or maybe we're let's figure out what's going on here. I'm going to inspect this turtle. 320, generation 13. I'll show you how I debug this. The problem here, reproduction is either not working or setting the generation. Parents die with generation younger than the current generation. Let's comment this out and see what happens for a second. The death isn't happening because we should have exponential growth now if I turned off the death, right? So there's something happening here when we step. So the current generation, parents die is doing nothing, compete for space. We're asking turtles, I wonder if that's the function that's causing all the problems here. Let's see. Okay, there's something about my compete for space. Ask turtles if any other turtles here die. Now the other turtles should mean turtles, not myself. We're asking all of the turtles. So any, don't think that's the problem. Let's comment just this part out. I don't think that this could be causing problem, but let's turn this back on. But I'm turning off just that second rule and compete for space. And I'm guessing that we're still going to have the same problem that we, and I guessed wrong. So let's go back to look here. This is the rule here that's causing, if any other turtles here die. So, okay. Oh, I see the problem. We need to have the other turtles, this rule here is killing off the offspring because when the offspring are born, this rule asks if there are other turtles there and then they die right away. I need to have those offspring disperse before we do the compete for space. So we reproduce and then we disperse and then we compete for space. So that's how you, these programs almost never work right out of the box. So you need to play around with, but I'm hoping that this works. So what I've done is I've said after you reproduce, then we, let's put the disperse right after reproduction. That makes sense, right? Get born, and then the parents die, those with a previous generation die, and then there's a compete for space. So let's see if just changing the order of those make a difference. Now I'm going to turn on the parents die. Everything's turned on. We just change the order of that. So set up, step. Okay, now we get exponential growth, and then we get a kind of a leveling off. But I'm not really seeing the reorganization. Okay, let's see. Step, 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 step. Huh. Not quite what I expected, but let's see if we have a little bit more greater need for space. That's a little bit more like I'd expect, and there is certainly a kind of sigmoidal curve. So, how about a need for a lot of space? So, slower growth and more variation. Okay, I think that the model, I would say this model is working. We have exponential growth, then a kind of leveling off. Now, kind of curious as to why we get a kind of frozen configuration at this point. point, but I'm sure that if we looked at the code, these are the kinds of questions that can come up when you build models. It gets real interesting to say, I wonder why that works that way. And if we had a different disperse procedure, we'd probably see something else. If I were to spend more time on this model, one of the things I would want to change is this disperse thing so that it was actually a bit more physically realistic. Instead of just having the turtles magically move to a patch, why not have them migrate, move forward until from their current location until they find an empty patch. It would be a little bit more code, but it would be certainly worthwhile and probably would create some interesting patterns. You could color different sort of families, and you could watch their migration and their success and failure over time. So I think that would be a neat project. Okay, finally, just to make the close the gap here, when I we have a step button that goes through one whole route here. The go button can just be a step button that has the forever attribute turned on. So now, and we should call this go. This is an important point to notice here. The display does not need to be the same as the command, but if you don't put a display name in, then the command name is used as the label of the button. So the display name is the button's label. So setup, step go, initial population space. We have a nice little model that has constraints. And at certain space settings, does an okay job of modeling exponential growth and a kind of a rounding off to a carrying capacity. So there you have it. John Bowen, signing out.